Hi, I'm David Wick, and today I want to talk to you about plantar fasciitis. It's a very serious problem for a lot of people. People have a very difficult time dealing with it and getting rid of it, and it can lead to all sorts of problems throughout the rest of your body as you sort of don't walk the way that you'd normally walk because of pain. So today what I want to do is I'm going to give you six things to help you remedy plantar fasciitis. And the first thing that we're going to do is we want to clarify sort of what it means and the real conditions that may be underlying this pain. And if you don't understand what's at the root, the cause, then you'll have a very difficult time making positive change. So we're going to clarify things and put you on a path to recovery. So let's look at the word plantar fasciitis, or plantar fasciitis, however you want to say it. Plantar is the bottom of your foot. Fascia is connective tissue in the bottom of your foot. It's all over your body, but in this case, the bottom of your foot. And then itis stands for inflammation. Now, the latest science is discovering through surgical procedures, removing tissue and examining it, that plantar fasciitis is often not inflammation at the root cause. Plantar fasciitis is actually oftentimes tissue death, which means that it's otis, as they would call it. That means necrotic. It means the blood's not getting there. It means the tissue's not being fed. It means the tissue dies. It means the tissue hurts. So if we look at the bottom of your foot, we have a muscle on the out or the inside of the foot that we call an abductor, and it pulls the big toe out. Then we have a muscle on the inside of the big toe that pulls it in, called an adductor. And the problem is that footwear traps the big toe. A lot of footwear traps the big toe and bends it in. And when you bend it in like that, what ends up happening is this muscle becomes shortened and tightened and restricted, so that when you take the shoe off, you have the toe is not capable of coming out. And a result, this muscle here, that muscle becomes lengthened and stretched, and the tendon that attaches it to the heel begins to choke off the blood supply. So there's arteries and veins that run directly underneath that, and they feed the fascia and ligaments underneath the heel. And when they get choked off because of that situation, what ends up happening is you basically, the tissue dies, and when the tissue dies, it hurts. And if you're treating inflammation, like I said, that's not gonna solve it. So I'm gonna give you six solutions, six things that you can do to help put you on the path to recovery from plantar fasciitis. So here's number one. Number one is something that we call the sock stretch. It's real sophisticated. You go into your drawer, you find an old sock that you don't care about, and it's gonna be your little training tool. And you loop it around one big toe, you loop it around another big toe, you line up the feet nice and straight, and then you spread the big toes. And that elastic is gonna give you a nice springy action that's gonna give you a stretch, and as you get better at it and put a little tension into it, flare and spread all the toes best you can, that you can see how it raises the medial arch. You're shortening this muscle so that it gives that blood supply relief. And so the way that you do this, because it's sort of a funny exercise, the way that you do it is you do it when you're doing something else. If you're laying in bed, reading a book, watching TV, just do it. You need to do it about 3 times a day minimum, because it takes a long time. It took a long time to get into the problem. It's gonna take, you have to work at it on a consistent basis to make change. So you do this underneath your desk, you do it in bed, you just do it. Don't go too hard, too fast. Don't feel like a joint dislocation or anything here, but get to the point where you can put some decent amount of tension in there, and that's gonna help start to rectify and alleviate the problem. So that's our first step, is the sock stretch. Now, the next step is ankle flexibility. And we're gonna stretch the ankle both ways, which is oftentimes not what people do. They only do one way. So what we do is we do something called plantar flexion, and we wanna do this one first. Plantar flexion is when we're bringing the bottom of the foot out this way, creating length in the front of the ankle. If you're not able to sit on your heels, and many people won't be able to do this, roll up a towel and put that towel underneath, and that's gonna give you a little support. And so find that level of stretch that's appropriate for you and just stretch that. You can roll into different positions on it, put a little pressure down into it, spread the toes, get that flexibility, and then I like to cycle it with what we call dorsiflexion, which is the typical treatment for plantar fasciitis. A little cycle between this downward dog action here that's gonna shorten this and lengthen this, that, and this. And you wanna do this flexibility at least twice a day. Morning and night will tend to work real well. You don't have to do it that long, camp out, you know, maybe 2-3 minutes cycling back and forth, and don't go too far too fast. All these things, you want to be very moderate in your application of it so you don't hurt yourself. Third thing that you're going to do is you're going to roll your feet. So rolling your feet, you have to do it in a specific order if you're going to get the best results. This is the bottom of a foot. Flip it so toes are down. This is the lateral, the outside. We're going to do that section first. Then you have the middle, which is called transverse, and you're going to roll that section second. And then you have the medial arch, which you're going to do third. You don't do this first because it essentially, anatomically, is above the outside. So if you release this without releasing this, you can actually create more problems. So I'm using the RMT rope to do this. The handle of it is perfect. And I'm going to camp out on that meaty section right here. Don't go to pain. You might have localized pain here, so you may have to sit down for these at first and only put the amount of pressure in where you don't have to grit your teeth and really like, it's hurting so bad. Back it off and just stay with what I call delicious discomfort. Has to have discomfort to make change, but it has to be the right amount. Use relaxation in your face as a guide. Now, you just go all that lateral border of the foot, spread the toes. See the way I'm spreading my toes out? That's gonna help as well. You don't want the toes to be all bunched in. Spread them best you can. And now we just get that meaty part right there. The transverse. This one is the most sensitive one in most people. You have to be very, very ginger with it at first. I like to go this direction toward the heel, and you can do both directions, but emphasize the toward the heel, and especially as you get close to the heel down in here, be very, very moderate with the tension. Sit down, like I said, as necessary. Now we get finally to the medial side, and the rope handle just works so well. Any cylindrical object is gonna work well. I like a cylinder better than a ball for the bottom of the feet. And you just find pain and make it go away. Get in there, find the tender spots, put the right amount of pressure in, do it consistently, and you will make change. So what you're gonna do with that is you're gonna do that rolling 2 times a day. You can combine that with the ankle flexibility. So that's the third thing that you're gonna do. Now what you're gonna do is you're gonna focus on nutrition, which is hydration and a magnesium supplement. Hydration is gonna give you a more fluid body, more flexibility. You don't wanna be dehydrated because you can't win when you're dehydrated. So what you do is if you drink a lot of coffee, make sure you counterbalance it with water. Just get enough hydration fluid. Water, herbal teas, the things that are gonna hydrate you and not dehydrate you are the key. A magnesium supplement works really well because magnesium helps reduce that tensed muscular action. Magnesium relaxes the muscles. So get enough magnesium in your diet, CalMag zinc tablets, easy to find, get that supplementation. Okay, the next thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna do Epsom salt baths. Epsom salt soaks for the feet because Epsom salt is a magnesium sulfate. So you're gonna create a localized reduction of tension with the Epsom salts. You can do that once a day. That's at the end of the day, at night. Maybe it's in the beginning of the day, but the end of the day tends to work best for that. So you go to bed, you get a full restorative night's sleep, and you had that nice relaxing effect through the feet. The last thing, sixth thing that you can do is you can use tape, like a kinesio tape. It's like a stretchy tape that you see the volleyball players, they have it on their shoulder. A lot of athletes wear it. And I like tape better than orthotics because an orthotic you can become dependent upon. A tape is a temporary situation. So if you take the tape and you stretch the tape and you run from here to here, now that tape is gonna be pulling in this way and it's gonna be complementing that sock stretch. And you can also take the tape underneath the bottom of the foot and increase the arch there so that you're gonna give yourself a temporary solution to get yourself out of acute pain. Acute pain is going to make you walk funny and it can lead to all sorts of problems. So the tape is sort of like address it in the acute stage, but don't become dependent upon it. Now, a bonus thing that you can do, and this was how I fixed my problem of plantar fasciitis when I had it 15 years ago, and I got it pretty severe. What I did, I didn't know all these steps. What I did was I created the BOSU ball, and training on the BOSU ball gives your feet all this intrinsic movement, and it makes them very strong. And the stronger your feet are, the stronger your body is. That fixed it for me, just that. But if you want to really accelerate the healing, you do those six things. You do the sock stretch. You do it 3 times a day. You know, 3 minutes for a session. That's all you're going to need. And you can do more if you want, but don't go too far too fast. All right? So that's your first. Then you're going to do the ankle flexibility 2 times a day, 2 to 3 minutes. That's enough. Now you're going to do the rolling, those 3 arches. You want to do that for 2 to 3 minutes. If you need to do that a little bit more, if you find a spot, feel free to spend a little more time in there, get it. You're going to keep hydrated, and you're going to take a magnesium supplement. So that's your fourth thing. Your fifth thing is an Epsom salts bath or soak, and that's going to give you that relief of like localized. And then you're going to use kinesio tape if necessary. And if you have access to a BOSU ball, bare feet works fantastic on a BOSU ball for fixing your feet. When you fix your feet, you're going to be absolutely so happy, and your whole body will operate better, and it's not an easy thing to do. I want you to take 2 weeks, do these steps exactly how I outlined them. Again, don't go too far too fast. Don't get impatient with it. It took a long time for you to get into this hole, and it may take you a little bit of time to get out. So consistency is the key. Spend 2 weeks doing these things. I want you to share your success stories, and I want you to share issues as they present if you're not successful. And we want to uncode this, de-scramble this egg, and get you on a path to recovery. That's how you're going to tackle the problem of plantar fasciitis. Thanks.